Hi everyone, and welcome to part 19 of The Sims 4 Get Famous. It's about a month after Tommy and Emmy's breakup, and Tommy and Carlos are now living in a swanky high-rise apartment in San Myshuno. And while Tommy was, of course, absolutely heartbroken over the breakup at first, and is still a bit upset, he's still got some lingering heartbreak from it, he's now realized that it was probably for the best, and that there was always something that was a bit off about the relationship, and that he may not have had the purest intentions when proposing to her, because he did, of course, love Emmy, but he's realized that his judgment was definitely clouded by the fact that she is so famous, because he really wanted that level of stardom that she had, and knew that by proposing to her and getting engaged and getting married, he would definitely get a huge boost and would really get him what he wanted. And that probably led him to propose in a situation where he may not have in other relationships. So in a way, he's actually thankful for Emmy breaking things off, because he just, in some ways, he just feels a bit better. Like, I just really think the two of them were holding each other back, and now that they are apart, they can really get to their full potential. Because, I mean, in Emmy's case, she was kind of worried about what he would think of her pursuing an acting career, and then in his case, she was kind of making it a little bit hard for him to get to know his son better, because she's always kind of disapproved of Carlos living there. Now he doesn't have to worry about that. He can make a space that's better for his son, because I didn't get a chance to tour their apartment, to show you their apartment before going here, but Carlos does have more space in their apartment for him to pursue his passion. So I just think it'll be really good for his relationship with Carlos. And, you know, he does also have those feelings with Glenn. So even though Glenn is married and that doesn't make things complicated, he now has a little bit more freedom to potentially pursue that, because honestly, I feel like he and Glenn could be a better match if things were to potentially work out with the two of them. I just feel like there was definitely more of a spark between the two of them there than there was between him and Emmy. So I just really think while their breakup with each other was hard, it's really for the best, and it's really going to open up a lot of doors for the two of them. Okay, so what have we got? Tell a director you are ready, practice acting, gossip with someone on the set. So let us find someone to gossip with. So we can gossip with Saya Burrows, who we already know. So let's go over here and do that. Oh yeah, because this is the Critters of Mauve and Forest gig, I think. I gotta look at what this is, because we did pick this a while ago. Yeah, he did, of course, have this. So we are doing two acting gigs, a couple parts in a row, so hopefully that's fine. Yeah, Critters from the Mauve and Forest. So hopefully do well. And look at that. He's actually in a pretty good mood today. So, you know, maybe won't have any. I mean, we did get rid of the... Okay, good. So we got some royalties. I mean, we did get rid of the emotional quirk trait. Or, I mean, the emotion bomb quirk. So that will make things a lot easier here today. So what are we doing? Are we... Okay, we're gossiping. So we're going to take care of that. And then we got to practice acting. Unfortunately, he hasn't really, yeah, we haven't really completed a lot of these. So I'm not sure if we want to go risky with it this time. Because what do we need? All right, doesn't really have an acting skill requirement for a promotion. But, I mean, we might be good. We got his level 10, level 7 acting skill. So I feel like that's enough that we could still do the risky interactions, even if we haven't, you know, done all the prep. So let's go over here and practice acting, so we can do that. Okay, so we got the gossiping done, so we just got to ask someone about their day. So we'll do this. I'm sure we'll get something else that pops up. So it looks like this is our background actor, so they are dressed up as the Void Critter. So I guess he's going to probably wear the same Void Critter costume. So we definitely want to have him get into costume. So that'd be really cool. Like, it'll be interesting having him do more of a kids show type of gig. And the thing is, like, now that we've got both Emmy and Tommy in the acting career, I'm not sure if I should really be showing each of the gigs, because I don't want to make it be too much acting in this series, because we're essentially going to have two parts of acting gigs in a row and then one part without them. That might be a little too much. So what I may do is, if we get to a point where we're starting to do repeat gigs, I may just not show them, or I don't know. Let me know what you all think. Like, are you fine with me showing both him and Emmy doing all of their gigs, or do you want me to just send them alone sometimes? Let me know, because you guys are the ones watching this. So obviously I want to do what you want, or, you know, what makes you happy. I don't want to bore you with too many acting gigs, but I mean, personally, I have fun doing these, but I don't know if they're really the most interesting thing to watch. And in the last part, Techie74 did bring up that it could be interesting to go in different directions. We'll just go over here and ask him about his day. But anyway, Techie74 brought up that it could be interesting to kind of go in different directions with Emmy and Tommy's acting, like not really put in a lot of effort to make Emmy better at acting and just kind of have her perform poorly at her gigs and see if she could still get promoted despite that, because the last gig she got a silver medal and didn't really do that good, but she still got a promotion because they pointed out that there are some people who aren't particularly good actors but still have really good careers. So I think that could be interesting to have Emmy be worse at acting and see if maybe her star power will carry her and get her promotions easier, whereas on Tommy's side, he's actually really good at acting but isn't quite as famous. So I don't know, just kind of see how those two different approaches do. So I think that could be interesting just to make it not too much of the same old with the two of them being actors. Oh, and I also wanted to mention that the reason they are living in the Uptown District rather than in Del Sol Valley, just in case you didn't see this, people, where I made the apartment, is that Techie74 also brought up in the comments of the last part that it didn't really make a lot of sense for Tommy and Carlos to live in the Mirage Park. And I thought about it, and I agree, because my logic was that, you know, as I said, I think I said the last time, I don't remember if I did or not, but I was kind of thinking, like, he's got money, but not money like Emmy, so maybe he could have a really nice house in Mirage Park. But then I realized that even if he lives in a really nice house, Mirage Park is still a fairly unsecure area and probably not somewhere you would find a fairly famous actor and YouTuber. So I think moving into the apartment in the Uptown District definitely made a lot more sense. And just because this is a Get Famous Let's Play, I don't think that means we need to stay in Del Sol Valley. And plus, we're still be playing as Emmy, and she lives in Del Sol Valley, so, you know, we'll still be getting someone living in Del Sol Valley, so I think it's fine. It just definitely makes a lot more sense to live in a really nice apartment, and even though it's nice, it's still not quite as nice as Emmy's mansion, so I think that does still work with my idea that Tommy has money, but not nearly as much money as Emmy does. But we're going to go ahead and get notes from the director, and I think that's it. Yeah, right. We should definitely get into costume for this gig. So we're going to go over here and get into costume. I'm not sure if we need to do hair and makeup, because, as I said, they might just be dressing us up in one of those big costumes. And if that's the case, then we don't really need to bother with hair and makeup, because you're not going to be able to see that anyway. So we're just going to go over there and get that taken care of. All right, come on, let's stop talking to people. How are we feeling? Okay, so he is starting to want juice a little bit. Yeah, he was feeling so good when he first walked into here, but yeah, now he's starting to feel a little worse. But at least we still have that overridden by his confidence, because he's feeling born for this from the self-absorbed trait. He knows that he is really in his place here on this set. Like, he knows that he's really doing what he is meant to do. So I just feel like, you know, while the breakup seemed like something that could have definitely driven him to a darker place, I just feel like it's really given him this release. It's really something he's realized is actually a good thing. But I'm not sure if we'll still have him stay friends with Emmy or not. I don't know. Like, that's kind of hard after a breakup, but maybe in the future they can kind of, like, okay, yeah, we don't need to hair and makeup. But yeah, he would just want to do a bold pickup line on someone. So he's feeling a little romantic, you know, a little bit of romantic from the confidence. But let's go over here and tell the director that we are ready, get into our gigs, and tell director ready to perform. And I think he got a promotion to, so I think he was at the same level Emmy was last part before she got her promotion. So maybe we'll get a promotion this time. That would be really cool if we could. And it would be even better if we could finally get that stardom boost and finally get him to be a 4-star celebrity. Because it is about damn time. I'm really wanting that to happen. He's so close. Carlos is also at the exact same point. They're both really close. But the director's ready, so let's see what we got. So we got a singing scene, and then we got a dancing so far. So let's go here, and we're just going to go for it. We're just going to do risky sing. I think it'll be fine. Hopefully it will be. Hopefully he's got enough of an acting skill to carry. And I think he also has does he have a guitar skill? He's got level 1. Okay, so hopefully that's not what that's pulling from. But this set is really cool. I like how it's like I think it's supposed to be kind of like a Toy Story-esque thing. But wait, hold on. Okay, I was worried for a minute that he just vanished. But I feel like it's supposed to be kind of like he's a toy come to life, which is pretty cool because, you know, we're kind of in a sized up kids room set type deal. Okay, I don't know what's going on, but I can hardly hear him sing. I don't know if it's the costume or he's just failing or what. Okay, I think he's done with that. That was kind of weird though, because I could hardly hear him singing. I don't know if that's a costume or what it was or some kind of glitch, but let's go over here. Okay, so it looks like we got two different dance acts. I mean, I guess that went pretty well. We got a pretty huge boost. So let's do Risky Dance Act 1 and hopefully this goes a little bit better. Rebecca. Okay, so that one did not go as well. It looks like he broke his back a bit. That was not good. Okay, I know you gotta pee, but we don't really have time for that right now. Okay, so let's do risky dance. Or maybe we should play it a little bit safe, because that did not go very well. And oh, great, now he's angry. Okay, so, yeah, he's starting to feel a bit worse now. Okay, hopefully we can just get through this gig and do well. How bad does he need to pee? He's going anyway. All right, that's fine. Well, all right, but how much time do I have left? We got 1 hour left. Okay, I guess we had enough time for him to go to the bathroom anyway. But yeah, that did not go well. So yeah, I think we should probably play it a little bit more safe. And then hopefully, I guess we have something over here afterwards. So I'm really hoping that we can get this up to a gold level gig. We might not be able to. I don't know, the safe dancing might not be enough. But yeah, I guess him not really doing as much prep is kind of catching up a little bit. Okay, I guess that one went a bit better. So we got the guitar scene. So we got something else to do that will hopefully... let's try... I think we could do a risky guitar play to guitar scene. We'll try it and see how it goes. Okay, that was really short. That was hardly anything. He just barely played and then ended. Okay, well, we got a gold gig though, so that went pretty well. That's a wrap. It's only 5 p.m., so we still got plenty of time left in the day. So I think what we're going to do with the Russell part is have Carlos's family over for dinner, because, you know, now that they're not living with Emmy, they don't have her not really wanting other people over, because they did have them over for thanks for Harvest Fest, but she's a little reluctant to do that. But now they don't have to worry about that at all, so we're going to have them over for dinner to catch up and see the new place. Let's see, that's a wrap. Tommy's finished all his scenes. I don't know if he got a promotion or not, but we did get a fame boost, so I feel like maybe finally be... Ooh, yeah, I think he actually did become a proper celebrity, so we'll have him go home, and then we'll see if that did happen for sure or not, but I think it did. Like, I just heard the sound like he got his fame level up, so I think we finally did it. He finally became a proper celebrity. Like, I just feel like things are really going better for him now that him and Emmy are apart. Like, we finally accomplished this now that they're broken up. Okay, so he made 1,250 simoleons, which is pretty good. Yes, he did it. He is a proper celebrity. The walk, the talk, the look. Tommy's a proper celebrity. The general public now considers it a big deal to catch a glimpse of him out in the streets. When he's amongst his adoring fans, he can incite cheers and really kick the crowd into a frenzy. Tommy has also got the appearance of being a public figure nailed. Why, he's literally a shining star. And he's got a new walk style that only a celebrity could pull off. Both of these can be adjusted simply. Okay. So that's really cool. We finally did that. Yes. Oh, yeah. This apartment also has a free maid service, which is really neat. Like, this is just a really awesome place. So for free, someone's going to come in and clean every day, so they have to worry about that. And then Carlos is also home from work. And what is he making? I don't know if he's... Oh, he's serving ceviche and chips. That's perfect. But let's actually go ahead and set up that dinner party. I'm just going to do it as a dinner party, just so I have to deal with Sims trying to leave too early or anything like that. So let's do, where was dinner party? There it is. So I'm not going to do a gold event because I'm not really going to pay attention to that anyway. We're going to have the two of them be the hosts. And then as far as guests go, let's pick his whole family. Hopefully they're all available. Okay, so we got Charlie, Christina, and Vanessa. Good, so they can all come over. And then we're not going to bother with hiring a caterer because it looks like Tommy's already on preparing things. And then, yep, we're just going to have it over here. And as far as start time goes, what time is it? It's 6 p.m. So I think we'll do, let's do 7. Yeah, so that'll give us like an hour to set things up. But he's, it looks like he's a little low on fun. But I want to have him go up here and do something over his fame blog just to see if maybe that'll push him over the edge and get him to become a four-star celebrity as well, because that'd be really cool if we could do the same thing for him as well. So where was that? Okay, here it is, a fashion blog. Yeah, so we'll just update that. Why not? I don't know why that's not working. Okay, so we'll just try having him sit here on the chair first and then do it. Sometimes that's what you have to do. I don't know why, it's just like a weird glitch. Or I don't know if it's something with specific chairs, but career, fashion blog, and maybe that'll do the trick. All right, so how are those VJ? Okay, why did you stop? Oh, okay, he's just... Oh, yeah, I gave them all of the fancy toilets in this apartment. So we'll resume the VJ and chips. I'll just give a quick tour of this apartment just in case anyone misses speed build and, you know, isn't really into checking out speed builds. But Yeah, this is the main area. We just got the living room, dining room, and kitchen, of course. I just really like how open it is, and it's definitely got this luxurious and glamorous, but at the same time modern feel to it. And then this is the laundry room over here. We got a nice deck area. And then upstairs we've got Tommy's bedroom and then an in-home gym. And then this really let's start. And then this really nice master bathroom over here. And then this is Carlos's bedroom. And he has his very own bathroom. And then over here is kind of like an office area. So Carlos has a space to do his style influencer related things. So we've got a wardrobe, like one of these things where you can do people's outfits for them over here, and then a makeup station, and then these clothes. So it's just a really cool space. And then I can also have him style these mannequins at some point. I don't think we'll bother with that in this part. But the dinner party has begun. So we'll have him go down here and greet them. Hold on, what is this? You're a whale in the fish tank, Bubby. They threw a script at you, written by the backup squad writers. They dressed you up in a goofy costume. They turned you into magic. Or you then you turned into magic. Word is spreading around the town. Prime time and movies are in your future. Ooh. All right, so let's have him go over here and say hi to Charlie. And oh wait, hold on, that is him. We'll just have him go down here and introduce himself, because I guess the two of them hadn't really got much of a chance to chat prior to this. But we'll have him come down here and say hi to everyone. So what can we do? Let's ask about day. And oh, we need to have him take a shower because he is reeking. Okay, let's just go take a shower. Just go. Okay, good. You're taking a shower, not a bath. Yeah, 'cause bath. Yeah, you just realized he stank, buddy. I think he was talking to Christina though. Maybe she. Oh, cool. Oh, that's really cute. Yeah, she came upstairs to talk to him. That's adorable. Okay, so I thought Carlos was making a serving of those, but apparently not. So we'll actually go over here and whip up something for all of them. So what can we? Oh, you know what? Actually, let's do. Let's go in here and do a party size serving. So what should we make? He doesn't have. Yeah, he only has a level 2 cooking skill. So unfortunately, he can't really do anything too fancy. But you know, it's a thought that counts. It's fine. So we'll go ahead and make a party size serving of tofu tacos, and he is really excited to have his family over here and to more freely be able to invite people over, because Tommy doesn't really have as much of a problem with him inviting people over as Emmy did. So, you know, if he wanted to, he could have his friends over here, although he hasn't really talked to them in a while. He's been kind of distancing himself from them a bit, you know, since now that he's a hotshot celebrity and there are still nobodies. But it's just cool that he can have people over when he wants now. And Vanessa's also feeling better about the situation as well, because she was really worried after what happened at Studio PBP, but then Carlos had talked to her about it and told her how Tommy took a day to just talk to him and try to guide him, and it made her really happy to see that Tommy is making more of an effort to spend time with Carlos. And I mean, she's still not like super keen on the whole thing, but she's feeling a lot better about the situation, and she's also really impressed by how Tommy bought a place, you know, or rented a place. You know, he probably bought this place. This is probably the kind of place you buy, but she's just really impressed that he found this place with Carlos in mind and, you know, just kind of purchased something with Carlos's hobbies in mind. It gave him a space to really be able to do what he wants. So she's just definitely feeling a lot better about the situation and is just impressed with how Tommy has been kind of showing that he really cares about Carlos. So let's just go here and talk to her so we can thank you for coming. Let's do that. It looks like he finished making the food though, although they're helping themselves to PB&Js when he took this time to make delicious tofu tacos for all of them. So this is kind of a mess of a dinner party, but I mean, this isn't really supposed to be a formal thing. It's more so him inviting them over just to show them this new place. You know, like he was showing, I'm sure he was showing Christina his new work area where he could potentially bring over clients. I don't know if he can exactly, like, through the career, bring over people to do makeovers, but I think he can at least invite people over and say that they're over there for him to give them makeovers. Or maybe we can have him give Tommy a little bit of a makeover, like maybe just change up one of his outfits, because he does have a few outfits that aren't really the best. Like, some of them are nice, but we can maybe have him kind of fix up Tommy's worst everyday wear outfit, just kind of give him a little bit of a new look to help him a little bit. So that could be really cool. So maybe we'll do that in the next part. But we'll have him chat a little bit. I don't know. I'm not too fussed over the fact that they're not eating the food that he prepared. So we'll chat with Christina some. And what is Tommy doing? What is he? What's he up to? He is okay. You don't really need to bake a cake right now. I thought I. What are you doing? I thought I told you to take a shower. Come on, go over here, take a shower. I don't know why he's just in his bathrobe reeking. Like, what did you even do? Come on. All right. Well, I mean, this is more so for Carlos anyway. He's just kind of not really participating much, but I'm glad you went and took a shower. Like, I just don't know what was going on there. But well, oh, what is going on with the fangs? Oh, right. These are the joys of apartment life. So we got the two of them go over here going, or the two of them over here making a ruckus. So let's have him go here. Like, he's kind of angry. So let's have him go here and pound on the door. He's just frustrated. He's trying to have this really nice meal with his family, just showing them this nice new place he's living in. So we'll go over there and just pound on the door. Let's not bother cleaning that up right now. Let's just go over there. I mean, he should probably knock politely, but he's just fed up. Oh, I just realized we still need to pick Tommy's new perk, so I need to do that before the end of the part. I will definitely do that. But we're just gonna have him go over here and pound on the door and see how it goes. And yeah, the Fangs are living over here, and I actually did go ahead and make them 3 stars celebrity just because I felt like they would definitely be kind of famous because Victor was a fairly known, well-known politician, and then Lily was a CEO, so I felt like it definitely made sense that they'd be celebrities. Yeah, so he's a B-lister. So let's, although it does look like he's a fan of his, that's kind of cool. So let's complain angrily about noise. See if we can get him to shut up. I don't know what they're doing over there. They're just having a party, maybe just playing loud music for the two of them. I'm sorry, you're right. That was a bit inconsiderate. We'll try to keep the noise down. Thanks for letting us know. Good neighbor. Aw, that went well. That was nice. So let's have him go back in here and talk to Christina some. And it's really nice to see that they still have such a high relationship because they have always been really close. And it looks like they're all having fun. You know, they're enjoying themselves over here. She's having a blast dancing. So what can we do? Let's ask about school. Just see how her grades are doing and all of that. And what else do we have? So we can ask about food, see how she liked. Although she didn't really, I don't think she really ate yet. She just ate a sandwich. But I guess we'll ask how she liked the fancy peanut butter and jelly they probably have. Like, I'd imagine they'd have some really high quality, like organic peanut butter and jelly, like the fancy stuff. So we'll ask how she liked that. It looks like he, okay, never mind. He's not, I was about to say, it looks like he's feeling better, but he's not. And this is the outfit I had in mind that I think we need to fix up a little bit because that is definitely his worst outfit. Like, it's just kind of not as nice compared to his other one. So we'll maybe in the next part just have Carlos go in and give him a little bit of a makeover. Just fix up that one outfit. But let's go ahead and give him that new quirk or that new perk. So he's got two new fame points. So what should we do? So this one over here was fan favorite. As a celebrity, Tommy will cultivate an army of fans that'll be at his beck and call. He'll be able to ask any fan to signal boost the fame or reputation of a household member of his choosing whenever he likes. He'll also be able to strike a pose to dazzle nearby fans, causing them to faint for his own amusement. I think this definitely is a good one for him because he is very self-absorbed. And then we have instant besties, so Sims can't help but be drawn in by Tommy's charming personality. Greeting a Sim with a casual word and beaming smile is enough for them to instantly feel at ease. So we could do that. Then we also have Career Hopper. So Tommy will enjoy certain benefits in the workplace thanks to his fame. When joining a new career, he'll be hired at the highest starting position. He'll also enjoy increased job performance and fast promotions as bosses will want to keep their famous employee happy. So I think this would actually be good for him because that'll really help us with getting promotions with his acting career. So there we go. Those are our new perks. And I'm still waiting to see what this is gonna populate with. So that'll be interesting to see in the future. And I don't believe he got a promotion yet. So he's still a supporting actor, but that perk will definitely help him a lot. Oh, that reminds me, I do need to pick a new gig. I kind of forgot to do that. So let's see what we got. Let's see if we got anything new. If we don't have anything new and I have to pick a repeat, I definitely won't show it. But it looks like we got some new stuff. So what have we got? ZBB Apocalypse Rising. Oh, this is with that really cool apocalypse set. I think I want to do this one. And then we also got Detective Law. We did this one. We've done these two, so we're not gonna do those. So I'm really feeling ZBB Apocalypse Rising. So that is Sunday at 12 p.m. Yeah, I think we'll just go ahead and do this gig, but let me go ahead and read the description. So it says, gritty and silent star needed to play a brave anti-hero in a post-apocalyptic thriller. It started with just a few small bugs. They grew and multiplied. Soon they gobbled resources and spread across the world. Before they knew what happened, the nations of the world were swarmed and infrastructure crumbled. Now small bands of heroes fight to rebuild society while combating those looking to revel in the chaos. That is really cool. I thought it was gonna be more of a zombie kind of a thing, but it looks like it's more of a, like, just some overgrown bugs are ruining the world kind of a deal. It looks like Vanessa's helping herself to our workout equipment, which is kind of odd, but whatever. And then I believe Emmy's gig was on Saturday, so this doesn't interfere with that at all. But we've got develop your fitness skill, which should be easy. Develop your guitar skill and practice action scenes. So you should definitely be able to complete all that before that gig. But he is sleeping. The dinner party's about to end. So I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap this part up here. So if you enjoyed the video, thanks for watching and bye.